She heard, or thought she heard, the child calling out, not whimpering like a child, but calling out clearly. Or that's how it seemed. Calling out, "Woman, please help me." Not whimpering like a child, but calling out clearly. "Woman, know this. Whoever does not hear a cry for help, but covers up their ears and walks on, will never hear the soft call of a lover, will never hear the blackbird sing at dawn, will never hear at sunset the weary sighs of workers in the vineyard as the angelus rings out." Hearing this, she went back to take a last look at the child, just for a moment or two, just to stand near him till someone else came, the mother perhaps, or someone or other. Just for a moment, just before leaving, the danger too great to think about staying, the town filled with fire and lamentation. Terrible is the seductive power of goodness. For many hours she sat beside the child, till evening, till nightfall, to the first light of dawn. She sat too long, she saw too long, the quiet breathing, the tiny fist, until as morning came, the seduction was too strong, and she stood up, bent down with a sigh, picked up the child and carried it away, like stolen goods, she carried it away, like a thief she slipped away, like a thief she slipped away.
Since the events in town, people have no